Welcome everyone. So today we are on with our non-comparative scaling techniques. And in non-comparative scaling techniques, we have itemized rating scales and Likert scale is one of it. In business research, actually, first of all, the Likert scale was developed by Renesis Likert. And it is extremely popular for measuring attitudes because the method is simple to administer. With the Likert scale, the respondents indicate their own attitude by checking how strongly they agree or disagree. Their attitude is checked regarding whether they agree or disagree with carefully worded statements that range from very positive to very negative towards the attitudinal object. Respondent generally choose from 5 different alternatives. A situation is given and then they are asked to mark. This is 5 alternative scale, Likert scale. But many a time, it is recommended not to use this, neither agree or disagree, because marking this is very easy for them, very convenient. They feel very convenient in marking neither agree nor disagree. But if I give them only the 4 scale, then they will be forced to present their attitude regarding that particular statement. So for an example of a study of measuring attitudes towards a game, maybe like cricket, I can ask them this question. It is more fun to play a tough competitive cricket match than to play an easy one. And then the 5 scales are given. Strongly agree. With 5 points, agree, not sure, disagree, or strongly disagree. To measure the attitude, the researchers assign weights or scores to the alternative responses. In this example, the scores 5 to 1 are assigned to the responses. Strongly agreement of the respondent indicates the most favorable attitude on that particular statement, and the score 5 is assigned to it. On the other hand, strong disagreement of the respondent indicates the most unfavorable attitude on the statement and the score 1 is assigned to it. If a negative statement towards the object is given, similarly, if this was a positive statement, so for the strongly agreeing, the highest points are assigned. If a negative statement towards the object is given, the corresponding scores would be reversed. In this case, the response strongly agree will get a score of 1 and the response strongly disagree will get a score of 5. It all depends upon you. You will decide whether the particular statement, the statement should always be a comparative statement. Is it more fun? It should always be a statement in a asking format, in a questioning format. Is it more fun to play a tough competitive cricket match than to play an easy one? I might find it a positive response if they strongly agree. That means the most positive attitude is towards playing a competitive cricket match. And the researcher who finds this as a negative statement may assign 0.5 to strongly disagree, because he might be researching on that an easy cricket game is always a fun. So it actually depends upon that how we are taking that particular statement and using it in our research. Likert scale may include a number of items or statement, not necessarily one. It may be many. It depends upon the number of factors we are there in search of. Maybe like we think that there are 7 or 8 factors which on which that particular object or our research object depends. So we may build up 5, 7, 8, or 10 statements to check on those factors. So it may include a number of items or statements. Each statement is assumed to represent an aspect of an attitudinal domain related to, connected to one of an important independent variable. For example, if we can see in this table on the screen, this shows the items in a Likert scale to measure opinions on food products. I want to know about the different opinions from its sample related to food products, and let's see what different statement they have developed. If the price of raw material fall, firms too should reduce the price of the food products. And since the researcher is researching from point of view of the food product producer, you have assigned point one on strongly agree. For him, one means a greater connectivity. It all depends upon the researcher what kind of scale you would be using, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There should be uniform price throughout the country for food products, another attitude. The food company should concentrate more on keeping hygiene while manufacturing food products. And how these particular statements can be devised? कहां से मिलेंगे ये हमें सारे स्टेटमेंट? इट ऑल अगेन बेस्ड ऑन द जनरल सैम्पलिंग. कुछ लोगों को सेलेक्ट किया एंड यू कीप ऑन आस्किंग एन इनफॉर्मल इंटरव्यू सेट. विद हेल्प ऑफ इनफॉर्मल इंटरव्यू सेट यू कैन गेन दीज थिंग्स एंड देन यू नीड टू कन्वर्ट देम इनटू स्टेटमेंट्स. दिस टेबल इज प्रिपेयर्ड. नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू विद दिस? ईच रेस्पोंडेंट इज आस्क्ड टू सर्कल हिज ओपिनियन on a score against each statement. The final score for the respondent on the scale is the sum of their ratings for all the items. सबको अगर हम add up करेंगे तो वो sample number 1 के लिए हमारा point आ जाएगा. Sum of all the responses. Like for sample number 1, points would be assigned to sample number 1. Actually, the very purpose of Likert scale is to ensure the final items evoke a wide response and discriminate among those with positive and negative attitudes. एकदम entirely positive class को अलग कर देंगे, entirely negative class को अलग कर देंगे, और फिर देखेंगे whether we are able to discriminate between these or not. Items that are poor or items which lack clarity or items which lack or items which are illicitly mixed response pattern are detected from the final statement list. In sabko bhi view karna hota hai. Answer to the first and the last one should match, but wahan humne ek mein strongly agree likha hai, ek mein strongly disagree likha hai, usse clarity ye bhi samajh mein aa jayegi ki respondent ne bina padhe marking ki hai. उन सब रेस्पॉन्सेस को फिल्टर आउट करना होगा. हाउएवर मेनी बिजनेसेस रिसर्चर्स डू नॉट फॉलो दिस प्रोसीड्योर एज इट इज लेंदिंग एंड वन मे नोट एंड वन मे नॉट बी इन अ पोजिशन टू डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन हाई पॉजिटिव स्कोर्स एंड हाई नेगेटिव स्कोर्स बिकॉज इट माइट हैपन दैट ऑल स्कोर्स लुक अलाइक. ये सिचुएशन भी आ सकती. Hence, the basic disadvantage of Likert scale is that it is difficult to know what a single submitted score means. ये total करने के बाद ये 18 का मतलब क्या होता है, ये कभी कभी पहचानना इस particular scaling में थोड़ा difficult हो जाता है. Many patterns of response to the various statement can produce the same total score. यहां 5 नहीं दिया, यहां 3 दिया, ऊपर 3 दिया, नीचे 5 दिया, तो भी वो स्कोर 18 ही देगा. वन मोर डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ लाइकर्ट स्केल. सी देयर इज लॉट ऑफ एडवांटेज ऑफ दिस स्केल बिकॉज इट इज द एक्चुअल पैटर्न टू फाइंड आउट द एटीट्यूड ऑफ द सैंपल. बट देयर इज वन मोर डिसएडवांटेज टू इट दैट इट टेक्स लॉन्गर टाइम टू कंप्लीट देन अदर atomized rating scales, because, and it is quite evident, the respondent have to read each statement. बोले ना, थोड़ा महंगा पड़ता है, महंगा पड़ता है एज फार एज टाइम इज कंसर्न. क्योंकि इफ आई गिव देम 20 स्टेटमेंट टू रीड, समटाइम्स तो दे आस्क द पीपल अराउंड कि भाई स्टेटमेंट का मतलब क्या है ये बताओ. सो दिस थिंग ऑल्सो टू बी केप्ट इन माइंड वेन वी आर प्रिपेयरिंग अ लाइकर्ट स्केल, कि स्टेटमेंट ईजी सिंपल भाषा में होने चाहिए. लैंग्वेज शुड बी सच दैट इट इज ईजी टू अंडरस्टैंड. एंड अगर ऐसे प्रांत ऐसे देश में जा रहे हैं वेर इंग्लिश डजंट वर्क, आई ऑलवेज सजेस्ट टू राइट स्टेटमेंट इन दैट पर्टिकुलर ज्योग्राफिकल एरियाज लैंग्वेज. एंड डिस्पाइट ऑफ दीज डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ टाइम कंजम्पशन, ऑफ फाइंडिंग आउट द एक्चुअल मीनिंग ऑफ द सबमिटेड स्कोर, दिस स्केल इज actually very useful. Why? You know, it is easy to construct, administer and use. So if you as a researcher want to go in for at least factor analysis to start with, or identifying the important factors associated with that particular research object, we need to find the attitude towards different factors of the sample, and for that Leichhardt scaling is a must. Use it. Thank you for hearing. I'll see you soon. I'm Mohit Jain, signing from MJ Magic Studio, that's MJ's Maths and Stats. Thank you.